Hello dear friends, ladies and gentlemen. This is Uncut Fishing, and you may recall this stack of rocks from my other video. I'll put the link in the upper right corner right now or in the description, and I can see there are trout rising in there. Oh, again. So today I'm trying to do a sequel to that video, and I will start at this dam. Okay, let's go. There has been some rain since I last was there, but not a lot. What's that? Oh man. First impression is not good. What is wrong? Okay. A tangle, very unexpected. For some reason the spinner is spinning the line. I'm using an old swivel, lost my spinner the last time I was fishing, probably left it on the roof of a car and drove away. But this is just pathetic. Just two casts. Yeah. I was hoping that fish activity will improve after this change in air temperatures, but this fish, oh, okay, spoke too soon. Oh man, I had a landing net but thought that the hook is well into his mouth. It was a rainbow. If I use the landing net, it would be mine. But all is not lost. Hello dear friends, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, it's been almost 2 weeks since what you saw just now, and I'm back because I feel I've got some unfinished business with these rainbow trout, and we'll see. As you may sense, this particular area is still short of rain and does not look very good. That was a take, definitely a take. I can see the fish movement. Whew. Oh man. All right. think I had two takes. Both times couldn't hook the fish. Trout activity is still pretty low as far as I know. But these are not brown trout. Oh. Very strange takes. Come on. Come on. It's a shame. There's a bunch of them in here, I feel. That was a snag. Yeah, so it's very poor. Could it be that this attempt at catching one will fail? Yep. Let's go around. Look at that footprint. No, this is not a footprint. I thought it was a footprint. So, I'm not sure I should even be casting the spinner. Oh man, now I am in trouble. Now I am in trouble. And I mean serious trouble. Okay, I broke off the spinner. I will pick it up later. Now I need to put on something different. Okay, give me a moment, I will be back with something different. Okay, so I put on almost a random crank, the one that I found on the branch someday, Usami 38 FSR, and the fish are rising, would you believe it, in that home, I think. Okay, back to my trusty spinner, and this time with a streamer, TW number 2, not large. I don't know if these fish prefer maybe larger lures, but they're picking up small insects from the surface. I've seen more rises here in the past, I don't know, in 10 minutes than I've seen in the past 3 years combined. A fly fisherman would rip this place apart. Probably, I don't know. They are ignoring the spinner. Complete ignore. Yeah, very strange fish. Oh, man. Okay, so that's the closest I got, but this was not large. Retrieving against the current very slowly with stops. Oh, I will keep on using this spinner and we'll move upstream. And and maybe I will think of something when I'm returning. Semi-blind cast and not good. What is that? I was about to leave. Straight into my face. Okay, let's go, folks. Rainbow trout 1, me 0. This is unnecessarily complicated. So I get a feeling that rainbow trout also prefer areas where they can move around. Brown trout could easily sit in there and just look for food that goes by. I don't know. Again, my experience with these fish is very limited. Okay, so we are approaching the spot where I landed. So far my only trout, rainbow trout in the stream, on tape, that is. But you will see how different that spot will look. It will look very shallow and transparent, I suspect. Oh, this is not a rainbow trout. A small, teeny beeny brownie. So brown trout, they like these types of spots. But this is very small. Okay. Approach this thing from here. Oh, okay, so there is a fish. There is a fish, and also by the way it behaves, it's probably a rainbow. Swipe. Okay, why? See? It seemed like a swipe, but I felt nothing. What are they doing? It's a nice fish. Probably the same fish that I caught. Sitting in the corner. Yeah, they are difficult to catch. They are much more difficult to catch than I thought. Some animal barking. I almost feel as if I was lucky to catch that trout several weeks ago in here. Maybe I should use even smaller lures. I have no idea. think I will have to concede the defeat. Unless I come up with something on my way back. Yep, folks, that's it. There will be nothing interesting stream. So I don't know, I will try something on my way back. And see you then. Okay, I'm backtracking to the car, and now I remade my tackle or whatever to float. Very primitive, no leader. I put the leader on, but then changed my mind. Just a hook, pretty large one, but some people would find it small. I find it pretty large. Rubber worm, wacky style, one split shot, and float. And I also double checked the rules, and it appears it is perfectly legal to use natural bait for rainbow trout. So we'll see. I don't remember, did they have a fish sighting here? Oh, hello. That was nice. This worm is floating by nature. Yep, that's where I saw the fish. And I think that I saw two of them. I'm 90% certain that there were two, at least two, because I saw them next to each other. Again, it could be an illusion. Here it is. Let's do it professionally. Oh. Very difficult to grab on to. Man, no, it is much more slimy than this regular trout. Oh man, spit the hook, fortunately. Here it is, 30 centimeters. Actually take it, and if I catch a good one, I will probably take it. I definitely have the right. And by the way, speaking of the rights to take this fish, it is not native to this water, as you may already suspect. And catching it reminded me of a problem, or maybe not a problem, but rather the reality of modern life that is, that can be summarized using one term, Anthropocene. I think this proposed geological era has not been officially recognized yet by the association which determines what geological developmental eras there are, but I think it will be recognized inevitably if it haven't already. And basically the idea is that humans have such an influence on the earth that the residue that we left is big enough to constitute a new geological era. And by that they mean plastic, metal, glass, etc., all of those things that we have left in the ground. But also I would add to this the changes that we make to the ecosystems. For example, this fish, it should not be here, but it's not such a big problem. But if we take, let's say, New Zealand, they pride themselves almost, they treat brown trout as almost national treasure worth preserving and cherishing. But fact is, brown trout did not exist in New Zealand before the end of 19th century, or Australia, or USA, or North America, or South America. There were no brown trout in those continents. People introduced them, and for example, in terms of Australia, obviously those rivers had some fish in them. They were not so attractive from the angler's perspective, but they were natural native species. And who knows of them now? Obviously Australians do, but it's all about brown trout. They pretty much dominate there over those local species. And is that a good thing? I don't know. Are rabbits, rats, and various other things that live in Australia and New Zealand a good thing? I don't know. There is this very cool YouTuber, Robbie Alexander. His channel is called Robbie's Fishing, an Australian angler. Very cool guy. Check him out. So he likes fishing very small fish, streams for trout, even smaller than I fish. And he gets so excited when he lands either trout or what he calls a redfin. But none of those fish were in those streams before they were introduced by Europeans. None. Or for example, he walks on the banks and tries to avoid getting scratched by blackberries. Well, surprise, surprise, blackberries did not exist in Australia before they were introduced by Europeans. So we're changing the environment quite a lot, and I think that to a large extent, preserving natural species that are native to a particular region has significant value in it, not only in terms of, I don't know, ideology, but also in terms of variety. I think that movement of people will become easier and faster in the future, and we will be able to go cheaper to many countries, and we will want that variety. But now, for example, if we take trout fishing, we find brown trout pretty much in all best rivers all around the world. They are dominating there. Is that a good thing? I don't know. I'm not sure. And rainbow trout, for example, in a stream this small, they grow faster, they grow slightly larger than brown trout. And obviously the food resources are limited. So is it good that they're in this stream? Very difficult to say. It's fun fishing for them, but for the brown trout that are native to this water, it's no fun at all. Seems the trout was sitting in that corner, and I think it could be still in there. This was a pretty decent trout. I think the same one I caught several weeks ago. I have no doubt that if it's in there, it can see the worm. By the way, last time I was here, that you saw the excerpt in the very beginning, I tried this worm in that best of holes, but without any success. This fish, it hasn't left, but I didn't see it coming out. It's no longer in this particular corner. Okay, let's leave this one alone. Okay. Anthropocene for you, a tire. Okay, let's go around here. This stack of old trees is not very inviting. Okay, now I need a several caddis larva. Okay. There's no shortage of caddis larva here. Spend my entire childhood, a better part of it, fishing on them. Here they are. I remember there are several varieties. I don't know what that depends on. What is that? Are you kidding me? Now I raised a lot of mud. Man, did it have to snag? Okay, first of all, I will try the rubber worm. If it doesn't work, I will try caddis. I don't have any bait box, any box where I could put them. So, where to put them safely? Oh man, that's a nice rise. Okay, where to put them so that I can find them? Okay, I cleaned an area for them. I'll mark it with a stick. They can survive for quite a long out of the water. Okay. There is one here. Maybe I should have made a shorter cast and let it just float. But current is very weak actually. Oh, it took it. It took it, but this time I couldn't hook it. By the way, I'm not sure how they managed to hook the first one so successfully. This was a short cast. Another rise. Wonder if that's the same fish. Oh, I saw it. I saw it over here. The one that I saw seemed pretty decent. Yeah, it's cruising around. It's not standing in one spot. Could it be that this one is no longer interested in the worm? But it took it definitely once. Most definitely it did. But the strike was... Oh, it's here now. What are you doing here, fish? Zero attention. I'll try to increase the depth a little bit, but I think the depth is fine. Okay, one more cast because I just can't not do. Where are you going? This is just... Okay, so it took a while, but the rubber worm hooked it, but not into the mouth, and I think this one I will be eating. Sorry to those who think that fishing is about releasing fish only. Look where I hooked it. Nowhere near the mouth. Nowhere near the mouth. Okay. At least 36 centimeters, I would say. And it is going home, and by home I mean my home. Okay, so victory at last. Two rainbows under the belt. Let's see if we can get another one. And it just rose. And I have no idea how many are there. try to take. Oh man. This dam couldn't handle it. But the takes were as if I was using natural bait. Tick 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 several times. It was maybe slightly larger than the first one. Something in there as well, downstream. Yeah, so I was telling good words about the how difficult they are to catch, but they are pretty bad at recognizing this artificial worm. Rises have ceased. Could there be that there are only two trout in there? I doubt it. Try the zone closer to the rocks. Was that? No, these are snags. barely see the float. In the morning there was definitely one fish well under those, under the cover of those pollen. Maybe not now. Yeah, and the rises have ceased. Just for the sake of it, I will try to put on some caddis. So, I remember from my childhood that, no, this is a stick, the best caddis used to make the shells out of woody materials. Then there were caddis that were making shells out of gravel predominantly. They were slightly different usually. The most pleasant view for those who are not fishing on natural baits. This is a white caddis. Let's see if this one is different. White as well, but much fatter. Okay, let's see what we can do with this. Now I don't need a lot of depth. Some obligatory twisting around the tip of the rod. And here we go. I don't know. Was that an illusion? No, these are normal takes. Okay. I was pretty surprised by the first one. And by the second one as well, actually. So the caddis is gone. Annihilated. Where are they? They walked somewhere. I will need to pick up some more. Yep. They ran away. Let's go find some more. And that is it. And we have rising again. Man. Okay. You know what? Let's find some more caddis. Okay. I found a few caddis larvae. And what the heck? I will try fishing them here. Just like good old times. One there. Took on the rise. Oh, they are immensely slippery. Smaller than the one I got before. I still get the feeling there are larger ones in there. Maybe I should have put on a larger hook. I'm using the ways I've learned in my childhood, it was considered to that the hook was should be as small as possible, not as large as possible. I think I lost a lot of fish in my childhood because of that. Couldn't set the hook, but it's still fine. Saw the fish. I don't know if you can see this float because I can barely see it. I had a brighter float, but I chose this one intentionally, and there are more fish rising. Over there. I hope it's now approaching my bait. I snagged it. There is something directly underneath those fallen trees, it appears. Definitely. Let's try that one. There, I set the depth too high. There is no depth in there. was reckless. I would like to get the fish from underneath there. Here it is. Lost the hook, it appears. So just a release. Okay, can I get another one? I think there's one more over there. Okay, if I land one more, that will close it. Had to snag sooner or later, unfortunately very mild snag. Not large. The hook is deep this time. Don't want to swim it to swim away with the hook. Although it's pretty small, it can still kill the fish. Oh man, they are so darn slippery. Oh man. I'm glad we have brown trout as native species and not them. Actually, this one's pretty is bleeding. All right, folks. So with this fish, I say goodbye. Thank you for watching. As you saw, these rainbows, they are active but completely ignoring the lures. On the other hand, the artificial rubber worm and caddis larva did work. So that'll be it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.